Look at that cute little creeper crop. I hope it doesn't explode. Good Minecraft morning, everybody. This is Dr. Darok here, and today I am bringing you a mod review for the Magical Crops mod for Minecraft 1.6.4. And this is a mod about using magical essence to imbue the power of the various resources and entities in Minecraft, including extensions for other mods, in order to imbue them into seeds and grow your resources with magical crops. So I'm gonna get started on that, but if you came here looking for something specific, there's a lot of content in this mod, so I've conveniently placed annotations on the screen for you to navigate through the video, and if you do not have annotations on the device that you are using to view this video, you can view the description down below for time codes for where the annotations would take you. So, the first thing that you will need to do in order to get started with the Magical Crops mod is find yourself some essence ore. And essence ore appears below a Y value of 45 by default. That's configurable in the config files. And it spawns by default in veins of up to 4 blocks. And it appears in both the overworld and in the Nether. Whenever you mine yourself some essence ore, which requires at least an iron pickaxe, you will get, by default, I believe it is 3 to 4 essence dust for each, essence dust? Yeah. 3 to 4 essence dust for each essence ore that you mine. And so the essence dust, you will then take, and you can use it for just a couple of things. Essence dust, for the most part, its primary purpose is to A, create the weak infusion stone by surrounding a diamond with essence dust. B, use with a weak infusion stone to create weak essence, which is the next tier. And you'll see here in just a moment that there are several tiers of essence dust. And the final thing that you can do with the essence dust is to infuse coal with essence dust in order to make it more powerful. So there's the infused coal infused with essence dust. There is creating your infusion stone. Oh yes, it'll work with emeralds as well. I almost forgot to mention that. So after you have created your weak infusion stone and you've got some weak essence, you can take the weak essence and use it to infuse these different elements and essences into seeds. So in order to make a coal seed, you'll need to take weak essence, coal, and seeds. 4 weak essence, 4 coal, and 1 pair of seeds to get yourself some coal seeds. And the coal seeds can be used to grow coal essence. And right here, all 6 of these, that is the first tier of essence that you can make out of the weak essence. In order to do any more than that, you're going to have to upgrade your weak infusion stone to a regular infusion stone. And if you want to get the regular infusion stone, you're going to actually have to grow some of this from the first tier here, and then use it with your weak infusion stone. So if I grab my weak infusion stone and come over here and surround it with coal essence, you'll see that I can make a regular infusion stone, which will actually leave my weak infusion stone behind. As will, if I take the essence dust and create weak essence out of it, it'll also leave the weak infusion stone behind. So let me just put this back in the chest here. And you can take, with the regular infusion stone, you can take 4 of the weak essence and turn it into regular essence, as you can see here. The regular essence is used for the next tier of seeds, and so on and so forth. So the progression through the tiers of the infusion stones goes a little bit like this. There's the weak infusion stone made from essence dust. There's the regular infusion stone made from the weak essence tiered seeds, or essences, I mean to say. And then there is the strong infusion stone made out of regular essence tier seeds, which creates strong essence. The extreme infusion stone made out of strong essence tier seeds, which creates the extreme essence. And the master infusion stone, which can be used to create all of the essences, which you cannot do with the others. If you take a look here, the extreme infusion stone can only be used to turn strong into extreme. It can't be used to turn, say, weak into regular, for example. So the next thing that I want to go over is infused coal, and there is an infused coal item for each of the different tiers of essence, from dust all the way through extreme. And this infused coal is much, much more potent than regular coal. For example, just the coal that is infused with the essence dust will smelt a half stack of items as if placed in a regular furnace. That's 32 whole items for one coal and two essence dust. That's pretty potent. But whenever you upgrade to just the weak essence, you get an entire stack. With the regular essence, it will smelt up to 128 items, with the strong essence up to 256, and with the extreme essence all the way up to 512 items from one piece of coal and two extreme essence, which if you're playing with other mods, that can power a combustion engine for a long time. So the next thing that I want to go over in this mod is the actual seeds. And as I explained a little bit earlier when I was talking about the progression through the infusion stones, which is necessary if you want to actually use this mod to its full potential, you can create seeds that are imbued with all sorts of different elements and the elements of materials and stuff like that. And most of them have a recipe that's something like this. A given type of essence, the material that you are trying to grow or turn into seeds, and just regular vanilla Minecraft wheat seeds. And if you put them together in the crafting grid in a pattern like this, for example, you will get coal seeds. And that is an example of a magical seed. There are four different kinds of seeds added by this mod. There are magical seeds, elemental seeds, soul seeds, and non-magical seeds, and I'm going to go over all of those. The next thing that I want you to show you is some cow seeds, because who in their right minds wouldn't want to grow something called a cow seed? Cow seeds are made from the strong essence tier, and out of leather, four of them, four strong essence and regular vanilla Minecraft seeds, and that'll give you cow seeds, which is an example of a soul seed. There are many different soul seeds, and I'll get to all of them in just a moment. The other seeds that are useful for you to actually use in vanilla Minecraft, if you don't have any other mods installed, are all right here. You can make seeds out of glowstone, redstone, obsidian, lapis, emerald, nether, which is made of nether brick, experience, which has a pretty odd recipe. Let me show you here: an ender pearl, a blaze rod, a magma cream, and a gas tier. So you have to have found a nether fortress, unless you find those through find the blaze rod through some sort of other mean. There is also diamond seeds, gold seeds, iron seeds, and dye seeds. And I believe that is all of the magical seeds. And then as far as, oh yeah, there's also coal, but I went over that already. And then there are also the soul seeds. There are slime seeds, which are made out of slime balls, spider seeds made out of spider eyes, gas seeds made out of gas tears, wither skeleton seeds made out of four wither skeleton skulls, and that may seem pretty expensive, and extreme essence, of course, the highest tier, and that may seem pretty expensive, but I think it's worth it, in my opinion, if you take a look at what you can actually do with the seeds. There are also creeper seeds, and I believe that is, and skeleton seeds and magma cream seeds, which are all of the different soul seeds, and it looks like I missed ender seeds, which is a magical seed. And then finally, the elemental seeds are water, fire, earth, and air, and they will grow, give you water essence, fire essence, earth essence, air essence, And the final seeds, which is the only magical seeds that you cannot craft, are the essence seeds. And you can only get the essence seeds very rarely from breaking regular vanilla Minecraft tall grass, which is also where you get the non-magical seeds, which I will show you right now. The non-magical seeds are blackberry, blueberry, chili, cucumber, grape, raspberry, strawberry, sweet corn, tomato, and sugarcane. And if you don't want any of those seeds, they can be disabled in the config, I believe. But they grow a couple different types of new foods that you can use. And there are also a bunch of other new foods. So, squid and sheep will now drop squid meat and mutton with this mod enabled, which you can cook just like any other variety of meat. And this mod also adds the ability to cook red mushrooms, brown mushrooms, and rotten flesh and eggs into edible versions. I believe the dried flesh does not give you hunger. Let me just check that right now. Yeah, so that lets you eat rotten flesh without getting the hunger debuff. It lets you eat mushrooms without turning them into stew, and it lets you eat eggs as well, instead of making them into cakes or something, for example. Then there is also magical food, which restores 3 hunger and gives you health regeneration 3, which is just fantastic. And you craft that like that with a nature essence in the middle. Nature essence is a rare drop from the crops when you're harvesting them. I believe it's like a 20% chance drop to get a nature essence every time you harvest a crop. And any of the new added food items that you can grow with the non-magical seeds. The next thing in new foods that I want to show you is the squeezer. And if you take a squeezer and an empty glass vial and squeeze any of these non-magical seed crops, you can include, and also apples, which you can't grow with these seeds, but they're vanilla. The squeezer will squeeze it out into juice, and now you have nice drinkable juice. There's also one unique recipe that you can use with the squeezer that's a little bit different than the others, and that is the berry blast, which you make out of a blackberry, a raspberry, and a blueberry, as well as the squeezer, which you retain, and the glass bottle, which clearly you'll retain after you consume your berry blast, which sounds like a lovely mixed drink. I would love to have a berry blast sometime. Maybe I should invent that. But that's pretty good food, but the best new food added by this mod, aside from this, because this is pretty powerful, the best new food added by this mod is the stews, which you can make out of the different types of meat, corn, and tomatoes. So let me just show you the lamb stew here. The recipe for that is cooked mutton, an empty bowl, sweet corn, and tomato. And that'll give you this lamb stew here. You can do the same recipe with chicken, pork, and beef. And those heal 6 hunger. They are fantastic food. And really the topping, the cherry on the top of the added foods here. These are great for utility. Early on in the game, you find some mushrooms, but you don't have both, let's say. You can only make a red mushroom farm. You can still get some nice, convenient food that's not terrible. The next thing that I would like to go over is I'm going to show you all the non-magical crops real quick, because I really like the sprites for these. I like the way that they look. These are the blackberries, the blueberries, the grapes. Over there is the strawberries. I hear a zombie. Oh no. There are cucumbers here, chili seeds, raspberry seeds, strawberry seeds, sweet corn, and tomato. And those foods are all really good, and they usually drop seeds. I believe there's a chance that they don't drop a seed. That happened to me whenever I was recording the first take of this video. But it appears that they all dropped seeds this time around, so maybe it was a bug. I'm gonna toss these away real quick, and I'm gonna get over to the magical crops, which is what you are all here to see. These things are awesome, just awesome. I should throw these away too. Goodbye, Red Hot Chili Peppers. You didn't make good music anyway. So the next thing that I want to show you today is the magical crops. And you'll see that the magical crops have just beautiful sprites. I love the way that all of these look. Just look at that cute little creeper crop. I hope it doesn't explode. I just love the way that all of these look. The sprites are much better than they were in older versions. I saw a picture and it just looks fantastic. And let me go over them real quick in order of the way I have them planted. Here's coal seeds, redstone, glowstone, obsidian, dye seeds, which want to give me a seizure, iron seeds, gold seeds, lapis seeds, nether seeds, blaze seeds, diamond seeds. Look at that. That just looks glorious. And emerald seeds. And those are all of the magical seeds. Over here, I've got the elemental seeds, fire, air, earth, and water. And then I've got all of the soul seeds as well, the wither skeleton seeds, the gas seeds, spider seeds, slime seeds, skeleton, magma cube, creeper, and cow, of course. So I'm gonna grab some of these creeper seeds. Oh, wow. I love the sound it makes. It sounds like a creeper, but it's not. That's just great. And you always get one seed back at least, and there is a chance that is configurable in the config files for whether you get an additional seed or not. You always harvest one essence, I believe is the case. I don't think that there's a chance that you get multiples or anything. And that's those. I wonder if any of these others have cool sounds. Aw, spider sound, slime sound, skeleton, magma. Aw, I was really, really hoping the cow seeds would moo at me. Oh my. Oh, that's terrifying. Fantastic. So those are all of the different seeds that you can get in vanilla Minecraft without adding any extra mods. And you'll see that while I was harvesting all of those, I did wind up finding myself a nature essence, which is why I was sitting there smacking them in the first place. The nature essence you can get rarely with a chance that is configurable in the config files from harvesting any of the magical crops, and you can use that for a couple of things, including this right over here, which is magic fertilizer. You need 4 nature essence, 4 bone meal, and a diamond to produce 4 magic fertilizer. And you cannot use regular bone meal on the magical crops. Regular bone meal will work on these non-magical crops over here, but they will not work on the magical crops. The only way to instantly grow the magical crops is with the magic fertilizer, which, conveniently enough, does grow them fully all the time, unlike the way the bone meal now works. So what can you do with all of these different essences, you may be asking me? Or yelling at your computer screen in confusion. Well, there are a lot of things that you can do with these, and I'm going to go through them as quickly as possible. The first one I'm going to go over is redstone essence. Redstone essence can be used in a crafting grid in a shape like a chest to produce 24 redstone, and you can also use it with bread to produce speed bread, which heals you 2.5 hunger and also gives you the speed 2 potion effect for 20 seconds. There are a total of 5 of these breads, and I'll go over them all while I'm talking about the essences here. The glowstone essence is one of the most interesting ones in this mod. Let me go ahead and show you the recipes that you can use the redstone essence for. You can use the redstone essence to upgrade your regular stone to a strong stone. You can use it to create redstone dust, and you can also use it, all of the essences have these following recipes, and I'll talk about those shortly. That is the essence brick, the essence block, the stone brick tinted with essence, chiseled brick tinted, glowstone tinted, which you've probably already seen because I had it decorating the area earlier, brick tinted, wood planks tinted. So you can do that with all of the different essence, and glowstone and obsidian also have some special blocks you can make out of them, and conveniently enough, glowstone is next, so I will show you those in just a moment. If you take that same chest shape out of glowstone essence, you'll get 12 glowstone dust, which you may know makes 3 glowstone blocks. You can also use the glowstone essence with bread to create glowing bread, which gives you night vision for 20 seconds. And if I just go in here and show you the uses for this, it can be used for making the strong infusion stone out of a regular. And it can also be used for the bricks and tinted items. But it can also be used for light-infused blocks. Oak wood, spruce wood, birch wood, jungle wood, stone bricks, mossy stone, cracked stone, chiseled stone, bricks, and nether bricks. That's it, yeah. And if you infuse them with light, they will glow in the dark. Which, as you can see, actually, conveniently enough, I accidentally allowed it to become dark. And you can see that this area is still lit up because these are actually the glowing chiseled stone bricks, not the regular ones. They have been infused with glowstone essence to make them light infused, and they are illuminating the area. I'm gonna turn into creative mode in case any nasties spawn around me. I actually have an outtake that you'll get to see at the end of the video that I think is hilarious. You'll see what I mean. There's diamond essence next, which 8 diamond essence will produce 1 diamond, 8 iron essence for 8 iron, 8 gold essence for 5 gold, and these standard outputs right here can be configured in the config files. So if you want 8 diamond essence to give you an entire stack of diamond for your effort, you can do that, although I think that's a little bit cheap. Honestly, I'm pretty sure that 8 diamond essence for 1 diamond is already very convenient because you don't have to go strip mining. You can just grow your diamonds. Woo! Growing diamonds! Who doesn't love that, right? You can use the lapis lazuli essence to make 12 lapis. You can use the blaze essence to make 3 blaze rods. Emerald essence, 8 of them, makes 1 emerald. 8 ender essence will make 4 ender pearls. You can also use 9 ender essence filling up the crafting grid to make end portal frame, and there's one more recipe for it, I believe. Yeah, and you can make 8 end stone out of 4 ender essence. So that's pretty cool, I think, being able to make end stone and end portals, which usually you can't gather end portals or place them where you want them, and end stone is a limited resource. So if you have a server or something and everyone has just mined out all the end stone in the end, you don't have to worry about that anymore because now people can just make their own. They can grow their own, as a matter of fact, from the bounty of nature. Magical nature, of course. The next one is a very important one, is the obsidian essence, and I'll go and show you what you can use that for right now. You can use it in a chest pattern like the others to make 8 obsidian, and you can also use it to make tough bread, which will give you resistance for 20 seconds. Oh, and I skipped over the flaming bread, which gives you fire resistance for 20 seconds, made out of blaze essence. But there are a couple of other things that you can use obsidian essence for, which are extremely important. You can use it to make obsidian, of course. You can also use it to make an obsidian defender, which will put you out when you're on fire or allow you to swim in lava. And you can also use the obsidian essence along with gold essence to make infused diamonds, which is used for making more powerful diamond armor that has the enchantability of gold, and is also used for making these awesome essence items and tools, which I will get to later on right at the end of the video. If you want to see that now, there's an annotation over on the left-hand side. The other thing that the obsidian essence can be used for, which is also very useful, is you can create obsidian-infused wood planks, all varieties, wool, all varieties, and stained clay, all varieties. And what obsidian-infused blocks do is they're exactly the same as their regular vanilla block counterparts, except they are non-flammable and completely explosion-proof. So I'll get to show you that in a fun little sequence here in a couple minutes, but right now I'm going to finish up the essence. There is the experience essence, which you can use to make an experience orb, which gives you 40 experience, which I believe is enough to take you from no levels to like 5. There's also dye essence, which can be used in various patterns to make all of the different vanilla dyes. There is the nether essence, which can be used to make nether quartz, nether wart, nether bricks, all that cool stuff. So there's the quartz, the warts, the nether brick, the nether rack, and soul sand. So you can use that for all of those items, which is just great. If you don't want to have to go to the nether to harvest these materials, you can just do it like that. Then there's also water, fire, earth, and air, which can be used together for various items, including leaves, clay, dirt, cobblestone. And the water essence also gives you water bread, which will give you water breathing, and can be used for a couple of things, including snowballs with the air essence, filling buckets of water, making clay with earth essence. So those are all very cool, and I just want to go over the soul essences really quick and what you can use those for before I get on to the infused bricks and all of the different blocks that are added by this mod that you can craft. The cow essence allows you to create leather if you put it in a chest shape in the crafting grid, but it will also allow you to fill a bucket with milk and create raw beef. And all of the soul essence, by the way, before I go on, can be used to create bottles of enchanting. And it doesn't have to be 9 of the same essence either. You could take a bunch of creeper essence and a bunch of cow essence together, and you could still make it. It doesn't matter, totally shapeless. It doesn't matter which ones are where, as long as it is a soul essence, the essence from a soul seed, you can turn it into bottles of experience, which is just so useful. I always love when mods add recipes for bottles of experience, ways to bottle up your experience, and ways to avoid having to do the regular vanilla things in order to get more experience. I love the fact that you can get experience from this mod. You can farm experience, you can farm the experience seeds, or you can farm soul seeds and make them into experience. I think that is just such a great feature. So the other essences here, the other soul essences here, you can use creeper essence to make creeper heads, gunpowder. You can also use it with skeleton essence to make all of the different music discs. So that's very useful. Magma cube essence can be used to create magma cream. Skeleton essence can be used to make bones, skeleton head, arrows, as well as all of the different music discs if combined with creeper essence. Spider essence can be used to create string, spider eyes. Slime essence can be used to create slime balls. Ghast essence can be used to create ghast tears. And wither skeleton essence can be used to create wither skeleton skulls, which, as I said earlier, very, very powerful. Being able to grow wither skeleton skulls without having to continue to fight them. So the next thing I want to show you is the light-infused blocks. And if I turn it to midnight here real quick, you'll see it is dark outside, but it is not dark at my doorstep, because all of the blocks that are making up this little abode here, which is terribly built, I'm sure, because I did it very quickly, all of these blocks are light-emitting, except for this one. And there is a reason for that. These blocks act a lot like glowstone in many ways. They are considered to be transparent blocks, which means that you cannot place doors on them, you cannot place redstone on them, you cannot place ladders or torches on them. So that's a little disappointing, but really, the best use for them would be to scatter them throughout regular building materials instead of building your entire home out of them, I suppose. Just like over here, I had to put down a regular one so I could place the door there. That is just fantastic, but I'm going to go show you the next thing, which is the obsidian-infused blocks. Okay, so the obsidian-infused blocks have a couple of special properties, the first of which is that they are completely fireproof. They will not burn up, they will not have fire spread to them. They are as fire-resistant as obsidian itself is. So you will see here that those have gone away, and no longer do they... The fires have gone away, and no longer would a wool block catch on fire. So you can use these if you like the look of wool, or you like the look of stained clay or oak planks, but you can't stand the fact that they're just easily destructible, that they go down like nothing when a creeper comes by, then you should definitely try this mod out and get some infused with obsidian blocks, because you can use this with all the colors of stained clay, all the colors of wool, all the different varieties of wood. It's great. The other major thing that being obsidian infused will do is make your blocks blast proof. So let me get behind my little blast wall here and crouch down. Okay, it looks like my blast wall stood just perfectly. And all of this white stained clay around here that is part of my blast wall, none of that was destroyed. Back here was some light blocks, but those got taken out, of course, because they're not obsidian infused. Whenever it's obsidian infused, it's much more awesome. The next thing that I want to show you is the Arcane Fence. And the Arcane Fence is made out of wood that you have tinted with any of the types of magical essence. And the Arcane Fence can be placed around your crops to protect them. So I've got a creeper crop right here, and you may notice, although actually I can't see it right now. There we go, I saw one. You may notice that there are particle effects traveling between the crop here and the Arcane Fence. And if your Arcane Fence is set up, I'll show you the crafting recipe real quick. You can make Arcane Fence just like this, with 6 of any of the tinted wood planks, and it will make 16 of the Arcane Fence. And if your Arcane Fence is sitting next to a crop, it will kill any mob that it comes in contact with. So I can just sit here and you'll see instant kill for any mob that touches this. It probably does a significant amount of damage and would probably kill any modded mobs as well, although I'm not sure about that. Hey look, it's a zombie on fire. Fantastic. So, once again, obsidian-infused blocks are made just like this. You can take your obsidian and place it in the middle and surround it with any of the blocks that are infusible by obsidian, and there you have it. You can also glowstone infuse any of these blocks, any of the wood planks, stone bricks, and all the varieties, including mossy, cracked, and chiseled, as well as stone and bricks and nether bricks. The next thing that you can do to cosmetically spice up your area is to infuse any of these blocks, wood planks, bricks, glowstone, chiseled brick, or stone brick, with any type of essence to color them and give them this cool little, like, I guess there's, I don't know how to describe the design that's overlaid here, but very cool the way they look. Shown here is the diamond variety, and if you want to know more about those, you can check them out yourself. I'm not gonna spoil all of them for you, but they do all look rather cool. And you can use those just like this with your essence in the bottom center and the rest of the spaces filled up with whatever block you would like to tint. So, but over here, I do have all of the varieties of glowstone. I've got more glowstone just for you. If you want to go and like my video, I would appreciate that very much as a thanks for giving you all of this beautiful glowstone. I noticed that this one right here, which is the ender-tinted glowstone. Yeah, the ender-tinted glowstone. It matches very well with regular vanilla Minecraft grass, which looks really cool. I love this. Some people think that glowstone is an ugly block, but whenever you tint it and you can color it and you can make it look different, I think that it looks great. Finally, there are a couple more blocks that you can make out of your essences. That is the essence block, which is any of the essences that will work for this or this. There's a 12 in total, surrounded by stone. Cooked stone, smooth stone, not cobblestone. There are essence bricks, which are any of those 12 essences surrounded by bricks, stone bricks. And then there is the essence glass, which is made by cooking essence block in a furnace. So that is the essence block, bricks, and glass. Diamond is seen here, and let me just run into the creative inventory real quick. Grab you another one. I'm thinking lapis. Yeah, lapis. Oh yeah, I think that looks phenomenal. I love the way that this essence glass looks. There has obviously been, I like the way that there's a consistent overlaid, like, essence texture thing that goes over each of these. I like the way that it looks like there's, like, lines of energy, I guess, traveling through it almost. I'm not sure, like I said, I'm not sure how to describe that pattern, but I think it looks great. And that is all of the blocks that are added by this mod. Finally, there are two things left to cover. That is the infused diamonds and the special items. So I'm going to come over here and I'm going to toss some of this stuff away in the lavas, which I will get to use in just a moment for another display purpose. Oh no, my essence hoe! No, my hoe! Oh. So as you can see, I am wearing this infused diamond gear. And as you can see, it has a huge durability. This is the second tier of infused diamond gear. You make infused diamonds out of obsidian and gold essence surrounding diamonds, just like so. Gold essence in the corners, obsidian in the centers, and diamond in the very middle. And you can also do it the other way around. And that will make you an infused diamond. And you can use the infused diamonds to make all of these different diamond gear here. And it has the main benefit of this. The regular diamond has, on the chest plate, a maximum durability of 528. The infused diamond chest plate gets a slight boost up to 704, which is about a 40% increase. But it also becomes as enchantable as gold armor and equipment. So your enchantment points will go much further on the infused diamond because, of course, it's magical. And if it's magical, it's got to enchant more easily. Just look at Thaumium, you know? So you can make all of these different things in the same patterns as normal. And then you can also take those diamond items and you can upgrade them into an even more powerful version with much, much, much more durability. At least 3 times the durability, a little bit over 3 times the durability, as a matter of fact, of the already improved diamond chestplate infused. And you make those just like this by surrounding them with 4 extreme essence, putting the infused diamond gear in the middle, and it'll give you this slightly lighter colored diamond essence gear, which I think looks pretty cool. I feel kind of like a Ninja Turtle almost. And that is it for the diamond armor. There are also, this diamond chestplate, it has durability so high that you never have to worry about it running out. But it does have durability. Speaking of never having to worry about it running out, though, these essence tools are completely unbreakable. They do not have durability at all. And they are all more powerful than diamond gear. So, I'm going to go over the crafting recipes for those super quickly. There is, for the shovel, a diamond shovel in the center, a blaze rod at the bottom, infused diamond on top, so it's sort of shaped like a shovel, sort of, and 4 extreme essence around the outside like this. That'll give you your essence shovel, which is completely unbreakable. There is also the essence hatchet, which is diamonds, infused diamonds up here in hatchet shape, diamond axe, blaze rod, and extreme essence like this around the sides. There is the essence pickaxe, which is created just like this, with 3 infused diamonds on top like you're making a pickaxe, a diamond pickaxe in the middle, a blaze rod at the bottom, and extreme essence on the sides, 4 in total, and that'll make you your unbreakable essence pickaxe, which is better than diamond. The essence sword is created just like this, with 6 extreme essence on the sides, a diamond sword in the middle, a blaze rod at the bottom, and 1 infused diamond at the top. And the cool thing about this, in my opinion, is the diamond sword has 7 attack damage. The essence sword has 9 attack damage. That is a notable increase. And finally, the essence hoe, which I accidentally just threw one in lava. If I had done that in survival, I'd be so very upset right now. Because the essence hoe, although usually you would hear people tell you, especially if you've seen Corridor Digital's The Last Minecart, you would hear someone tell you that you should never use your diamonds on a hoe. But in this case, that is not right at all. Because for a total price of 4 diamonds, 8 obsidian essence, 8 gold essence, 2 extreme essence, and a blaze rod, you can create the essence hoe, which is a totally unbreakable hoe, but it also has a special ability which allows you to till a 3x3 area of land if you hold shift and then right click. So the essence hoe is extremely useful. It's actually, as a matter of fact, instead of clicking on all of the blocks over here for my magical crops individually, I just spawned myself in an essence hoe and created it like that, and it saved me a significant amount of time. It took less than, I mean, clearly if you're doing 9 blocks at once, it'll take you 1/9 of the time. You save almost 90% of your time on tilling the land if you're using the essence hoe. So, that is all of the infused diamond gear and the essence tools. And the last thing that I want to go over is a couple of special power-up items. The Obsidian Defender, the Health Orb, the Cobblestone Voider, the Water Orb, and the Experience Orb, which you've already seen the recipe for. So I'm gonna switch into survival mode for this part. I hope I'm not assaulted by any leprechauns. Okay, so the first thing I want to show you is the Obsidian Defender, and the Obsidian Defender has two purposes. If you hold right click, it will keep you from taking fire damage while you're in lava or on fire. You can just swim right through lava, no problem. And if you right click any other time, it will put out the fire that you are on. So it will pretty much completely protect you from fire. It is much better than having fire resistance. As long as you've got it on your hotbar, all you have to do is switch over to Obsidian Defender and hold right click, and you are totally fireproof. And it lasts for 50,000, or 5,000, I mean to say, durability, and which I believe means 5,000 ticks worth of fire damage, basically, that you are protected from. The next thing is the Health Orb, and am I still on peaceful? I don't think so. No, so if I jump in here, I take some fire damage. Oh wow, look at how resistant I am with this armor on. That's crazy. So if I take some damage real quick and I use the health orb, it will heal me 2 hearts. It'll heal you 2 hearts every time you use it. But it will still use, and it uses 1 point of durability to heal you 2 hearts. But if you heal less than 2 hearts, it will still use a full point of durability. Basically, if you heal the full 2 hearts every time, it can heal you a maximum of 300 hearts from a full durability. The next thing I want to show you is, well, let's see, I'm going to do the experience orb real quick. Let me just go /XP level 0/XP -9 levels. Yeah, okay, cool. So I'm down, I've got no levels, I'm almost level 1. I'm going to go ahead and right click my experience orb, and it'll take me up to level 3. So basically about 2 levels from about 2.5 levels or so, if you're starting out at 1. Oh, cool, and I'm gonna check out my essence sword. So here's a skeleton, and I killed it in 2 hits. That's all you need to know about the essence sword. The next thing I wanna show you is the water orb, which gives you night vision and water breathing if you hold right click while you are in the water. The night vision is a little bit flickery. I would like to see it last maybe like a second instead of like a half a second or whatever it is now, so that it doesn't flicker on and off. I would like to see it last all the way from the time that you activate it until the time that you next activate it while you're holding right click. That's probably a bug, and I hope that gets fixed because it's a little bit weird looking at like the landscape having a seizure. There's one last thing that I want to show you today, and that is the cobblestone voider. So I'm going to run into creative mode here. I'm going to grab myself a... No, actually, I didn't need to go into creative mode, did I? I'm going to go into survival mode again. I'm going to come over here and grab myself this essence pickaxe. And I'm going to run back to the underground over here. If I could just come right down here and go down my ladder here. The cobblestone voider is a very useful item that will automatically void cobblestone from your inventory. So if I turn it on, you will see that all of the cobblestone that was in my inventory very rapidly disappeared. If I continue to mine while it is on, you will see that the cobblestone appears for just a moment and then immediately goes away. into the void forever to never appear again. So that is pretty much everything that has that this mod has to offer at this at the time of making this video. I really hope that you have. Oh, did you hear that spider get killed by my arcane fence? Ah! Today I am bringing you a mod review for the Magical Crops mod for. Ah! That's terrible.